Welcome to this week's City Council Recap. My name is Chris Loos. We'd love for you to be a part of our recap team, so please send an email if you'd like, kgemtv@gmail.com, or you can reach me directly at Chris Loos Media on social platforms. We just love to have more people from our community joining us. And let me introduce you at this time to my co-host for this week's recap, Ms. Barbara Gholar.
Yay!
Thank you for joining me. You look amazing.
Thank you.
And for those of you who probably know Ms. Gholar, but if you don't, because I say this only because she serves on like more organizations and councils and groups here in the town than I've ever seen anybody do. Salute to you for that and the incredible work you do. Share about one of them that, if
well,
you don't mind.
Actually, it's interesting that you asked that because just this morning we had a meeting, and that's with the Interfaith Council of Monrovia. And it actually, it started with my sister. She was approached by someone in the city to have something really interfaith, to actually to bring all the different faith traditions that we have here in Monrovia. And so that happened back in 2011. So they had their first event in 2012. And so that's and our meeting today. Actually, we meet the third Thursday of the month, and what happened today is that two things are excited about is that we're going to start having the show right here on KGM.
Okay.
With all of us, you know, just having a conversation. And the other thing is what is neat is that because all we can really see how we're all kind of joined together. Mm-hmm. And some of the same kind of things that are happening, like with, you know, the hate crimes that just recently happened. We have our Jewish Federation. We had it didn't happen here, but the St. Luke's sister church in Pasadena, they had something going on, and then the Baha'is, not here in the United States, but have persecution in Iran. We have that.
I thought it was cool. I only knew about it because of you introducing me to it. And I thought it was the coolest because I was like, you know, for me, I feel like sometimes organized religion can kind of look like gangbanging from the outside, where it's like, you know, this set over here and this set and denomination there. And to see everyone's just kind of come together and it's just, it was cool to me.
Yeah.
To see. So I'll watch the show.
We're a really good group, and I really felt honored this morning in our conversation that was going on. Just because you saw the oneness, you know?
Yeah.
And so that was really, really nice.
So I know we're way off track
right
now.
Okay.
I think it would be cool to see, like, you know, go around the table at the invocation to start these city council meetings off, like from the inner, you know, faith council. I think it'd be cool to see different faith groups represented there. I think that'd be fly. Because I saw the invocation. Shout out. I forget the chaplain. I didn't write your name down.
His name is Mike.
Okay.
He's from the Filio Unity Center.
Okay.
I forgot what his title is. But I know his last name starts with an A.
Well, shout to you, Mike.
Yeah, he did a good job.
Now we're going to get to what we're here to do, recapping the city council meeting from Tuesday night, May 16th. This week's meeting was about 2.5 hours, kicking off at 7:32. Invocation, Pledge of Allegiance, roll call. Councilmember Crudgington was excused. There was a special study session on the budget. You can reach out to city staff for questions about city budget at any time. So if there was things that you weren't aware of, the city is where you want to go. Go to the city website and you can reach out to our city manager, Dylan Feek, on there to get the budget, or he can direct you to who you would need to get it from. After that, it was presentations and proclamations. They had Pasadena Humane Society bringing out a cool little senior pup named Winston. I say pup, he was a small guy, but yeah, he was a senior dog.
Yeah, he was, to me, he was big.
Was he? I like a big, big dog. Okay.
Oh, okay.
He was medium size. Okay, medium size.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, so Winston.
He was cute.
Yeah, yeah. You can see all the pets, PasadenaHumane.org. Set an appointment to see pets. They'll make the time so you can spend some time. But that's PasadenaHumane.org if you'd like to adopt a pet. PR2, Introduction of Community Activist Policing, presented by our police chief. That's 9 minutes in. When I first heard it, I was like, what is community activist policing? This sounds weird. But really getting to see what it was about and understanding how they work with different mental health issues and different calls of that nature to allow other cops to serve in different ways. So 9 minutes in, you can find out more. Thank you to Councilman Jimenez for asking what a community activist policing does. Before they got to the photo op time. Appreciated that shout for the clarity. PR3 certificate for student liaison Angelina Hamilton. Congratulations.
Yeah, and that was her last meeting.
Last one, she's going to UCLA.
Uh-huh.
She's about to be a Bruin, so congratulations to you.
Yes.
We've gotten to see her here at the City Council recap, deliver her student liaison report. So 12 minutes in, you can see Angelina, as it is her last time with us.
I thought that was really nice also that her parents were there.
Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. PR4, proclaiming May 2023 Public Works Week. Public Works Director Alex Tachiki received the proclamation read by Mayor Pro Tem Larry Spicer. That was about 15 minutes in, followed by Angelina's last student liaison report. State testing happening this week for juniors, so shout out to y'all. Hope you do amazing.
Yeah, and get plenty of rest.
Rest.
So you can take those
Stay
tests.
Hydrated.
Yes.
It's warm this week.
Yes.
And get lots of rest, yes. Also, senior recognition night on June 5th. So parents, put it in your iCal or your calendar if you haven't done that yet. If you've got a senior student, June 5th.
Well, I do have to say something mm-hmm. here really quick. I really, actually, in 93, we had lots of family members that passed away. And the following year, our family in 94 has been giving out scholarship in memory of our family. My dad, my mom and dad, and Tracy Gholar, her mom, it was also in this community. And then with the passing of Joni, my sister, it's now we now have three that we give out.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So I'm really happy.
How can a student get those or apply for those scholarships?
Well, actually, those scholarships are, one is for service. Mm-hmm. And one is for, because Freddie was all into the arts.
Okay.
So that's an arts mm-hmm. award. And then Joni's is GPA. Your
Got it. Yeah. Academic.
Mm-hmm.
Love it.
Yeah.
Love it.
I almost said GPS. That pause, I go, did I say that?
Caitlin Sims, who handles programming for COG, came in 22 minutes in and provided info on SGV care. It's like a 20-minute presentation and a great discussion that went for nearly an hour.
Yes.
Mobile crisis, mental and behavioral emergencies, specialists that can handle the calls. It seemed like a great service.
Yeah, and I would really recommend that you go back.
Yes.
I mean, if that is something that you're interested in, because
yes.
to be honest, we're not going to do it justice.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was so much detail that you need to go back and if that's what you're interested in, just go back and find that link.
Yeah.
Now I know I did a little bit after what the
It was about 41 minutes in. Dylan kind of discussed it in a break. Go about 40 minutes in. Dr. Kelly was definitely an advocate for mental health, the programs, the services. The rest of the council also agreed. I love that Council Member Jimenez asked about how maybe we could tie in the community activist policing with this. I felt like that was a great shout, and I think that kind of connects those pieces together. But there was also public comment on it. Jason Willoughby called in to thank council for funds allocated to mental health.
Ulysses was there.
Yes, Ulysses Gutierrez. Jason also shouted that the SGV care pilot is used in Arcadia, South Pasadena, and San Marino currently. Ulysses from Healing Connections spoke to thank the officials as well. He's been heavily involved with mental health for quite some time here in the community. Melissa Taylor also got up and spoke and shared about the crisis interventions being a way to be proactive, and also appreciated the pilot program, thought it was great. Also mentioned the Measure K funds, right? Like, that was something, I don't know if it's become an elephant in the room, but nobody talks about it anymore, and I'm sure it's being discussed maybe in closed sessions.
I don't know.
But, okay.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I think this is definitely something to spend funds on. From there, it went consent calendar 1 through 12.
Well, you know, I have heard that Becky had shared that on May 24th on Zoom.
Yes.
But I didn't get where you would, I guess you would just go to find where she stated. No, she said to contact her.
Yeah, contact her if you'd like to hop on the Zoom. It's the mental health ad hoc meeting. She mentioned that in her report.
Yes.
About an hour, 20 minutes in, Craig, who was administrative review needed about development on West Palm. He talked about it meeting all the requirements and needing final approval on the map. Nobody had any questions. And then there was public comment from Margaret, who lives on Palm, who spoke about how the neighborhood had changed. Reflected that the neighbors felt the same way, the overcrowding of the neighborhood. And also, when does the mental health and well-being of people here in the community become a higher priority than the dollar sign? I felt her as she spoke.
I know. Yes.
I felt her as she spoke.
Yes.
It's like an hour 20 in. Councilmember Jimenez agreed with not liking the Manhattanization is how he said it. And I agree with that. Like, but he also shared, like, some of it is taken out of the city's ability to control.
I was really happy. I don't remember who said that, and I usually write things down, that down. But I really appreciated that, because that is my, I don't like driving up Myrtle. I'm seeing those big things that are there. I don't. If I'm a passenger, I close my eyes so I don't see it. Mm. You know, because I was born and raised here. But someone said that the state has taken away some of that, the zoning things.
Correct.
So they have to do some of those things that's happening.
Yeah.
So that made me feel a little better.
Yeah, that was Council Member Jimenez.
Okay. So I did appreciate knowing that information, because, you know, I don't know if it was said before.
Right. I never heard it. It was good to know.
And so, right. Mm-hmm. And I also think that when big changes, especially every time you turn around, these buildings are coming up everywhere.
Yeah.
And so if people had this information and saying and making that statement, I think that would have been, I know I would have felt
for sure
better.
It was sad for me to see, and even in Margaret's face, you know, you could see that she went up and she's like, I know it's not going to go this way.
Yes.
But I got to come and say it.
I have to say it anyway.
And I can, and seeing her, and even hearing
her
you
body,
who have lived here in the community, I know it looks like a different Monrovia from when you grew up here, you know, like, so, unfortunate.
Yeah.
But it was moved, seconded, and voted through. From there, they went to public comment. Juliana Oñate from the Chamber of Commerce shared city events and stuff coming up. It's about an hour 25-ish on the link below. There's also a business seminar coming up, ribbon cutting, which they weren't able to do at Old Town Pizza. That is next Tuesday at noon. Shout out to Old Town Pizza. Have you eaten there, Ms. Gholar?
This is a new owner now, right?
Yes. So they're going to have the ribbon cutting and everything on Tuesday.
I ate there before the new owner, but I haven't with the new one. Yeah.
Like their calzone, their pizza.
I haven't had calzone in a long time. And I love.
Yeah. Go to that one.
Okay.
Go to that one. Okay. I'm going to oversell it, but I'm, you know, they're not paying me nothing to say this. I'm just being very honest right now. Anyway, calzones over there at Old Town Pizza next Tuesday for the grand opening, but they're open now. Also, shout out Monrovia Days this weekend. I'm excited about that. That's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Yeah. And I'm also excited about the Grand Marshal. I don't know if this has happened before, but I know that Ryan Blackshear Vargas is a Grand Marshal, a co-Grand Marshal. Mm-hmm. And Ryan also, when she was a senior in high school, was the queen
of
Monrovia Days. And so it's really nice to see that. And also, Ronald's husband is a co-marshal, so the both of them. So I'm really, really excited about that.
I'm excited to say like that Monrovia has one of the illest illustrators in the world right here. Like, look up Ron Husband if you want to see some of the amazing artwork, if you're not aware of him already.
Yeah, and you know, he was the first black animator at Disney.
Correct.
And graduated right here from Monrovia High School.
Yeah. He's one of my son's favorite artists.
Oh, like, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Melissa Taylor got up also at public comment, asked for the Diversity, Equity, Inclusion Ad Hoc Committee update. Also asked for the City Council to consider flying the LGBTQIA+ flag for Pride Month coming up in June. She also mentioned how the new bookstore in town experienced hate speech. I know that we've been talking about it on a few of these recaps about Monrovia declaring it, you know, a city that doesn't condone hate. And it was very unfortunate to hear that. That's an hour 26 in. You could see Melissa's comment. After that, Terry Prado mentioned the Monrovia Garden Club annual awards meeting Tuesday, May 23rd. At First Presbyterian Church, that's at 7 o'clock. You can come out, get inspired on how you want to do your yard. It doesn't have to be brown. You can use cactuses, different things. So something cool to check out. Jason Willoughby called in to talk about letting our youth be heard. Talked about the incident that happened at Library Park, which was, I believe, the bookstore incident also, that Melissa.
I think so. Where is that bookstore?
Right across the top of Myrtle. I've been by it. I haven't been inside yet. I forget the block, but it's closer up to the top by the park.
Okay.
Yeah, I think. Gosh. Okay. I'm terrible,
I'm going to go home that way.
Yeah.
A roundabout.
Yeah, and he was, you know, and he also mentioned, you know, I think we need to protect our business owners as well. He sent an LGBTQIA+ flag to the city and asked as well if they would share that in June. And then it was reports from city manager and staff. City manager Dylan Feek, an hour 33 in, gave his report. Council will be talking about the Art in Public Places Committee and how things are worded and set up. They were going to discuss verbiage and what they can do. So that's something being discussed. He also asked Fire Chief to come up and provide an update on the incident that occurred April 29th, hazardous materials.
But you know, before
program.
You go on with that, because I really appreciate the fire chief's presentation that he did and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But to go back in that Dylan, you know, it's wonderful technology. He had texted the Chief Allen about the incident that the people had reported, Melissa and Jason, and that he had stated that that there was not a report.
Yes.
So the police weren't called.
Yes.
For that incident.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. And shout to Dylan for taking care of that
right.
on the spot.
And so they're going to be checking. They're going to be investigating that.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I didn't want that to go.
Yeah.
You know, unnoticed that they didn't.
Listen and do something.
Right.
Correct.
Right.
Yeah, and do something instantly. That was cool to see. The slides are about an hour 35 minutes in. I stay not too far from there, so seeing everything blocked off, it was like, whoa.
Yeah.
So I watched the whole thing and be like,
I think
what
I had
happened?
Called here and David said, I think we're being evacuated. What?
Yeah, correct. Happening? Yep. Yep. I talked to David about that same thing. Yeah, that was something. That was April 29th. After that, Councilmember Jimenez talked about the Anderson House, visitors' thoughts on our town, and people just love it, you know, when they come to visit. They can't afford to live here. Unfortunately, they get a little sad. That was part of it, too. But they do love our town. Firefighter Pancake Breakfast, he said he got to see how the jaws of life are done and a whole demonstration on that. Also shared about Monrovia Days this weekend, Library Park. Mayor Pro Tem Spicer shouted, the champ is here, you know, very Ali-esque for the pie eating contest. Shout out to Merengue. That's like easily one of my favorite bakeries here in town. And their coffee's amazing too. But they provide all the pies for the pie eating contest. I guess Mayor Pro Tem Spicer has been, you know, representing.
Yes.
It's being represented. So, yeah, if you want to get down in the pie eating contest, I don't know which day it is, but Friday, Saturday, Sunday is Monrovia Days. After that, Councilmember Kelly.
Well, I want to say about also Sergio, Councilmember Sergio Jimenez's report, because I too was at Monrovia Reads Gala. And one of the things that they're implementing is Zoo Phonics. I worked with Zoo Phonics as a former teacher with my kindergartners,
mm-hmm.
and it's a wonderful program. And they're going to actually have that at I don't know the initials, but at the canyon at the preschool here.
Okay.
It's where they're going to start that because you know the thing is if you can't read. You know, that's really, really, really difficult. So, and then dealing with phonics, then you have better access because you'll be able to read anything because you sound it out phonetically. Because there are kids that learn how to read without knowing the phonics part of it. So,
sure.
Yeah. And our very own, which she's also a part of Monrovia Doherty Black Alumni, was honored was Keisha.
That's right.
Her
Darden.
Darden. Yes.
Yeah.
I was going to call her maiden name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's
so it
amazing.
Was a wonderful event.
Yeah, Dr. Kelly also shouted Monrovia Days. Get your ride tickets and all of that as well. She also spoke about KGEM raising $4,000 towards the Ralph Walker Memorial Paid internship, which I'm super excited about. Both you and I serve on the committee.
Yes, I'm really excited and can't wait actually to start the interview process for these students.
And to the interns that get it.
Yes.
Look, I intern for free. Y'all getting paid, okay? Y'all gonna get a little bit of money in your pocket. But May 27th and 28th, you can see the documentary, The Godfather of KGEM, airing out on television. Watch it if you can. If you did not get to look cinema to see it on the big screen, it's powerful. Like
I'm gonna say this on camera here. I'm so very proud of the staff here on putting that together. I was, you know, the first showing was sold out, and so I was sitting out as people came out, and they were just in awe on the film.
Yes.
Just everything about it.
Yes.
You know, we were, and then, you know, start making donations.
I saw the first cut. So seeing this, like, I kind of thought, I'll go see it again.
This was totally different.
This added pieces and gave context and
yes.
showed things that it was just very well
it
done.
It was very yeah. well done.
Salute to the team here.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, incredible. Council member, or Mayor Pro Tem Spicer, didn't have a report. Congratulations to your daughter.
Yes, I'm going to call Layla. I'm so proud of her.
Graduating the honors from Howard University, where President Biden gave the commencement speech. What a moment.
And she is just an amazing young lady.
Yeah, that's
amazing
awesome.
Amazing young lady.
That's awesome. Congratulations. After that, Mayor Shevlin gave her report, shared about the Islamic Muslim community that came out to thank the city for celebrating Ramadan. Also mentioned May 10th, receiving an email from League of California Cities to sign a letter on our current fentanyl crisis, which he sent over. Gave kudos to Monrovia Reads, which Mayor Shevlin also serves on the board as well. But that's 2 hours in. Mentioned also the mental health ad hoc meetings happening on Zoom. You can reach out to our mayor directly if you'd like that Zoom link. She will share it with you. Thanked our first responders for being kind and caring and efficient every single day. Definitely a tough job. Appreciate the work being done. Went from there to administrative reports. AR1, Alex Tachiki, to report temporary lease of San Gabriel Valley Basin, water rights, how it works. 2 hours and 2 minutes in on the link below, you'll see the full go. A lot of information on purchasing water, having it ready when needed. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right? He was advocating definitely to purchase the water now while it costs low. Definitely made sense. Our mayor recused herself at that time for the vote. Mayor Pro Tem Spicer moved to purchase. It was seconded by Councilmember Jimenez and voted through unanimously. And it's still important for us to be careful with our water, mm-hmm. even though we got all that rain. Mm-hmm. After that, Buffy talked about the budget.
Yeah.
My bad, Buffy. Y'all trying to put Buffy budget all there together.
Kind of blend it all together there.
Buffy talked about the budget update. That's 2 hours and 16 minutes in. There was a unanimous vote move forward on the budget. And it's a lot of details. Again, like, we can't go through all of that with you, but 2 hours, 16 minutes in, you'll see the full go of our city budget. Reach out to our city staff if you'd like to get that information better for yourself. They closed in memory of Brenda Trainer's mother and adjourned at 10:01.
Yes.
That's a long time.
Yeah, it's a long time.
I want you to know, like, you know, we really want to make this recap something y'all can enjoy and get tapped into. But it's work sometimes for Ms. Gholar and I and the crew here. So everybody who's on the team here, the recap, we appreciate y'all. We know that you love the community or you wouldn't do this. So if you'd like to join us, we have a mug for you here. You know what I'm saying? We have a seat for you here and we would love to hear your thoughts. KGEM-TV@gmail.com to join our city council recap team. And we would love to hear you. We will catch you on the next one.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.